Howdy everybody, this is Bake with IronThroneCraft.com. Today we're going to talk about building enhancements. You can enhance buildings to level 40 now, and they are pretty massive stats. However, in addition to being massive stats, they're also massive, massive resources. So, I'm going to go through and I'm going to talk about what are the most important ones to do, because most people aren't going to want to spend all of those resources to get everything up to level 40 right off the bat. Right? Just right into it. All the buildings that reduce leverage attack. So enemy archer leverage attack debuff 146.4 on the wall right there. That's a huge deal. Specifically if you're single type, or you know, even if you're multi-type, you still want to get these three done first. That's going to be the wall, the warehouse, and the command center. So the wall does archer leverage attack debuff. The warehouse does cavalry leverage attack debuff. And then the command center, as I'll show you in just a second, is going to do infantry leverage attack debuff. Additionally, each one of those buildings is going to give you that percentage on the defense as well. So here's a command center. So you get 146.4 leveraged infantry attack debuff, and you get 244% infantry defense. So for me, those three are the number one priority to get updated immediately, as quickly as possible. That's the biggest, biggest deal. After you get the leverage debuffs, go and do your prison. Prison gives attack, defense, and HP. Just base stats apply to all of your troops. Attack, defense, and HP. So prison's going to be right up there at the top of the list in terms of best things to do for you. Next, I like to do the watchtower. Watchtower was expensive, but it gives you siege defense, number one. And number two, it gives you enemy troop attack debuff, which is what we're actually going for. And you see at level 40, it gives 585% enemy troop attack debuff. So when I'm picking the building enhancement order for me, what I was doing is what would help me defend my base better. So that would be the three leverage buildings, like I said, the wall, command center, and warehouse, and then the prison, and then the watchtower, and then I would go and I'd do my single type buildings. So see how training grounds gives 244% infantry HP and 439% infantry attack? Obviously, we wanted to do prison before these ones because prison gives troop stats and these ones only give single type stats. But if you see, each one of these gives their type. So this one's Cav, 244% HP. What's odd is if you look at Siege, if you get that up to level 40, it gives 280. So it gives a little bit more Siege HP than you do off the Infantry, Archer, and Cav ones. But those are going to be your main buildings if you're trying to defend. It's going to be your wall, your warehouse, your command center, then your prison, then your watchtower, then your single type buildings. After that, you're going to be getting more into offensive stats unless you go and do the altar. The altar can still help you out on defense because it increases your execution buff effect. So that's a percentage increase on your execution buff. Depends on your altar level, depends on your altar enhancement level, obviously. But that's going to be a percentage increase on the actual buff itself. So that will also help you with HP and defense additionally, and some march speed and some attack. After that, I'm going to go and I'm going to hit the Hall of War for the troop HP debuff. See, and this is where now, this is what attackers are going to want to focus on, because you're going to get HP debuff off of that. The altar also gives defense debuff. And then now is when you start getting the rally troop stats. So these are the last ones that the smaller accounts want to do. See, the embassy right here gives 476% rally troop attack buff and gives some reinforcement defense. And then the marketplace here is going to give you some rally troop HP buff as well. And then a whole bunch of resource gathering speed and troop capacity. So that'll help out with your big tiled core invaders on your Alliance War days. But for me, I'm not going to focus on my Academy or on my Stronghold until later on, because see, Academy is just going to give you more research speed. That's 370%. If you take it up to 40, you're going to get more research speed out of that. And you take your castle up to level 40, and it's going to take you up to faster construction speed as well. So see how expensive that is? 48 billion for me to get an extra 68% research speed, 48 billion iron. That's a lot of resources for not that much research speed. So I'm not going to be focusing on my Academy, and I'm also not going to be focusing on my Citadel. You see, my Citadel is only level 22. Taking it up to 40, again, 46 billion wood, 10 billion silver, 28 billion iron. But I get a lot of construction speed out of it. So maybe I'll do that eventually, like if they keep on releasing resource packs like they did last week. I don't know. Maybe I'll get these upgraded eventually. But the bottom line for me is the first thing I wanted out of these building enhancements was I wanted to defend my base better. So, priority order for me, in my opinion, is going to be wall, warehouse, command center. Number one, get that leverage debuff. After that, you go to prison and you start getting your troop stats. You go to prison, then you go to watchtower for that a lot of attack debuff, then you go to your single type buildings, And then after that, you're going to go hit your Hall of War and then your Embassy and toss your Altar in there wherever you feel like. It depends on how good you are keeping Execution buff. So thanks for watching. Quick, easy. Hope it helps. Thanks for watching, everybody.